So, shall we begin the turn? Otherwise, that right up there.
No, we better keep going straight. Because there's one guy that's just a fly. The wing of the
airplane.
Yeah,
I got him.
This is helicopter Julie Julie Bravo R44. We have targeted 1,500 feet down for surface on 10 right if available. Receive Bravo.
Julie Julie Bravo, Arch, check it out. Say, ah, join Downway 10 right.
Downway 10 right. Julie Julie Bravo.
That was a bit wild, wasn't it? Yeah. Oh, that Warrior's a long way out there.
Sorry? That Warrior, he's mid-base now, but Cody's a long way down.
Yep.
Instruments,
yep.
Temp pressure green, switches,
yep.
So
switches,
lights,
lights on, and hatches and harnesses.
Yep, that's it.
Central block.
Yep, just watch your high scan.
Oh, yeah.
Chilling off off your runway 10 left, please land.
Yeah, so bring your hands up,
yeah.
And just reset and attitude.
Yep,
that's great.
Just remind me what I'm going to do right here on this turn. I'm going to take first stage flaps.
Yep,
so roll, power, flap. Right, so once it
looks out,
that's
roll clear.
Yep, so roll, power, flap.
85, flap.
Yep.
And then trim. So grab the trim wheel at the top.
Yep,
and move it to the bottom.
That's it.
Just forward about 9 o'clock position,
about there, on the right.
At half sky, half ground, and
I'm on about 75.
Yeah, so just set the attitude, don't worry about the speed.
So
the
attitude's too high there,
so lower the nose a bit.
I think we're going the wrong way there.
Yeah, so now.
Yep.
Hold. It's moving up a bit, so it's out of trim. Okay, so it's holding there.
Yep.
Give it a moment. That's starting to settle on the top of the truck. Let's see how that takes about 10 seconds.
Yep,
to settle.
Yep.
You,
you,
like a motorway,
third-stage flaps.
Yeah, that's right, doesn't matter. You can E65 with 20 degrees of flaps.
Yeah. Ah, fuck it up again.
Just idle. Stabilize the attitude. Okay, gradually raise the nose. Gradually. Flaps up. Add power. There you go.
So,
on the final there,
yep.
We're sitting at 85 knots. The profile was good coming out the numbers, we're just too fast.
Yeah.
What so, you do is reduce power.
Sure.
Right. So, do whatever you need to with your left hand to maintain the picture,
yep.
And just bring the throttle back.
Yep.
So, it's, we use the power to control the speed on the climbing.
Yep.
So, if we're fast, reduce power. If we're slow, add power.
Okay.
And then maintain your profile with the attitude.
Right.
That's a little bit different to how we normally do things as everywhere else. But that, what do you mean?
On
base we set the attitude for the speed.
Oh, right.
Generally speaking. So on final speed different because we're trying to fly that same.
Yep.
383.40 number.
Okay,
it's
down.
Hold it to 172 right base from my left.
So you just need to make some power adjustments there for the speed. So make a little change, wait for it to take effect.
Right.
And then, if it's not quite right, make another one.
Yeah, I was thinking of my attitude instead of the power for some reason. When the speed got fast.
Churchill Bravo, just extend that. We're back in a wide circuit. You'll be the following sling joining final from the southwest. He's about 3 miles out at the moment.
Okay, so take you in front, that's it. Switch the altitude, do it stable. So we're 45 degrees there.
Yep.
So roll power. Yep. Roll. Reduce the power. A little bit of back pressure to help you slow down.
Uniform Charlie going around.
35 degrees. Control wings all there.
On the 172.
Half star, half ground.
Additionally, one Charlie 15.
Except the picture. A bit less power.
We're about to go 1 0 left 29 and 240.
About there, is that about 75?
It's just that fast. Hey, you all clear there, funnel.
Enjoy your Bravo number 2, follow the short. Traffic started, George on the Bravo.
Uniform, Charlie, make a left circuit. Circuit, you don't need to, Charlie. This is good. Super fast, so just fly straight at the numbers with the attitude. And adjust the power for speed. So just take a little bit of power off to get us back to 65. So reduce the power levels. Yes. Let's go to numbers. And then the speed comes back. Idle. Land. The trees. He's about to beam us now. Yeah, we can make it. Alright. Yeah, sorry. I need the morning, sorry man.
lap left?
Yep.
Yes, so we're just saying take a lap. So everything else is the same, which
I got that. Oh, everything else is the same?
Yep. Okay, watch your heading. So you come to the left.
Yep.
So we're drifting to the right.
Yep.
Because we're going to take a lap,
yep.
We need a little bit of nose upstream. So when we turn, still think roll power flat stream, so yep. Just no flat.
Right.
Okay, so 45,
yep.
All clear, so roll power, yep. Get that power back. Pull the nose up, because we're taking no flat.
Power becomes really important. If you leave it too high, you get way high and way fast.
Really, really kick it. 1A10 left, please. Up you go, 28340.
Okay, we'll clear up final.
Well, so the wind's increasing from the south-southeast, currently 160 degrees, 9 knots, so all coffee.
Tunes are a bit higher. We want 70 knots.
Can you make this one a close circuit?
305, okay. We can go a close to 1,000 from 180 on it. That'll be great, thanks.
Churchill Grammar, thank you. And my 1-0 right, please stop and go.
That's it, just keep the nose there. Control your speed and power. Just keep that attitude.
go.
Alpha Romeo number 3, follow Sling, about to turn base runway left.
Nothing inside up, Alpha Romeo.
Sling, Mission Juliet, runway 10 left, please up to go.
Well, they want to go left, I like to go left. Sorry.
Yeah, because we tend to consistently drift away from the runway.
Okay.
And pull down it, so just be mindful of that. Make this a flash
signal. Oh yeah, I did it, yeah.
Julie Bravo, request circuit 1500 for 10 left. Is your right climb to 1500? 1500, 10 right, Julie Bravo.
Let me go for report leaving 1500.
1500 now, I'll let go.
Hold on, Miguel, thanks. Contact Christian Departures on frequency 118.45 today.
1845, hold on, Miguel.
Swing 8340 on my 10 left, please touch and go.
Hold on, 10 left, please touch and go, swing 8340.
There's a profile.
Flat.
Okay, so make a change.
Julie Bravo is down with 10 right for a 360-degree auto. Off we go.
Alpha Foxtrot Romeo runway 10 left, please touch and go.
10 left, please touch and go. Foxtrot Romeo.
Julie Bravo runway 10 right, please stop and go.
Down
me, glide, please, touch and go. Yeah. Please, Mr. Julie, copy, glide on my 10 left, please, touch and go. 10 left, please, touch and go, Mr. Julie.
Something happens there at like 150 feet. Something happens to the plane. The bumps.
Yes, well, it's probably that little bit of wind shear.
Okay.
You have that layer where the wind speed over the ground will be a little bit slower than in the air. A little bit different, so it feels that little bit of a sink. Like you're going through a layer there.
Catching up to this guy.
That's right.
Thank you.
Stanley 1-0,
left,
Sky 1,500.
Now, Fox, remake 1-1,500, number 2, follow Sling, Mike, Gambit on my left.
Climb 1,500, probably on Sling, and thanks for the perception, go out for Fox.
Now for Fox, remake.
So we gained a bit of extra height, it just gives us more time to fly, a bit more time to have a look at it. You're all strapped in.
And,
oh, here we are, 1,500. So we're Sling, a little bit ahead of us. Everything checks the time. The way we normally do this in the circuit, so this sort of simulates the last bit of a forced landing.
Right,
so we can see the threshold there.
Yep.
Our aim point will be basically where that first taxiway is in, so a couple hundred metres from the threshold.
That way you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. So that's our initial aim point. We will touch down closer to the threshold, but that's our initial aim point.
Okay.
So say, okay, there's the engine
track. 340 on my one turn.
Okay, so I'm just going to hold the nose up like that.
Let's start.
So we're not losing height, we're probably gaining a little bit. Okay, I see you're just about 70 knots.
Yep.
And I just lower the nose. That glide attitude.
Yep.
And
just
finish
right.
Right,
take it. We can just get it all out with the alpha, we'll be done.
And it'll settle down on about 70.
Yep.
Cool. Have a good look out. From around. And the Sling looks back to the runway. Yep. I don't want to give it too much longer. I'm going to turn. And now the only thing I have to control my speed is the attitude and the
trip.
Yep. So I just use 30 degrees angle back. Everywhere. Keeping it balanced as best I can. There we go on base. Now I'm rolling. Attitude. Speed settling.
Good.
And as I'm coming down here, monitoring the approach.
Yep.
So I try and sort of visualise the approach path coming back up to here, overhead the building to here. Okay, here, how high am I going to be where I'm standing out over there? It looks like I've still got plenty of height at this stage.
Yep.
You see that Sling there, he's well and truly lower than us, so
yep,
we're above his approach path, so we're probably okay. We've still got nearly 1,000 feet. A bit over 1,000 feet, right? Clear. And straight into that 30 degrees angle back. And we're very high, so I'm going to go for 85, straight to 20. Pause. There's the flat. Now I push. And then I trim. Because I went straight to 20, and you double hit a trim. So it's still on 70 knots. That's it. So it's in trim. Not touching anything. Oh, maybe it's still too low.
Okay,
I'm going to take a full flat now. Yep, pause. Push. There's a push punch. Bit of nose down trim.
Yep.
So at least 70. We're definitely going to make it now. Even though it looks like we're going to fall a bit short, hit the little taxiway there. Watch what happens. Even though it looks like we're going to hold short.
I get that illusion all the time then.
Yeah. Flare?
Yep.
So it's a bit more pronounced, the flare.
Yep.
So we don't want to overdo it. So we rise and we just stay here.
Yep.
Hence ground effect. And then just as it starts to sink. Oh, that was a little bit flat. My bad. Didn't raise the nose quite enough there.
Yep.
Barely up the power, 155 already. And away we go. There you go, glide approach.
Alright.
Makes sense. Yeah, so it's all a judgment thing, which will take a bit of time and exposure, so I'll help you guide you through the first series of it.
Okay.
Just so to tell you, you know, I'll take a flat now, we'll turn up a little bit wider, a little bit away. And it's just all about trying to maintain the glide speed. Actually, you definitely know you're going to make it, then it's not so critical. But we don't want to get slow, that's the problem. If we start to get too slow, then we lose our ability to... We lose the abilities over the wing. That's going to be dangerous.
Yeah, fly, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If we're fast, then we can always pull the nose up to slow it down,
strike,
things like that. If we get too slow, that's when it gets a little dangerous.
Yep. air temperature, 28.18.
Traffic worry, just see what the puncture left is a coach.
Oh,
but then
I see it in Celsius.
The left circuit remains at the outside of the aircraft. Away 10 right. Please take off, make left turn. Take off, make right turn, and we'll copy that traffic because here we go. Left turn.
So here we are, right downwind. And there you go, engine fire. So that's it. So attitude's there, start trimming, nose up.
Swing out your C40 on my 1-2.
There's your 70 knots, so set the altitude. Just adjust the trim so the attitude will hold a little bit lower.
70
knots. All clear. Round, lift the runway. Turn up the base. Turn 90 degrees. Maintain 70 knots. And roll out. Like so. Balance. Fresh that attitude. Yep, just set the attitude. I chase the speed, so that attitude's too high there, but I'll set the attitude. So it looks like we've got heaps of armor. But that's good. If you actually take one stage of 15 and then... Yep, take one stage. 45, one stage, pause, push, and trim. Nose down trim. A little bit more. Okay. You're all clear in final.
Roll out for Foxtrot Romeo. Runway 1-2, let's go. 45.
We may land long, but that's okay. As long as we make the runway, that's important.
Right.
We'll work on getting it accurate back to the numbers.
Yep.
So just hold the attitude, maintain 70, and let it come down. So we can accept it landing a bit long, but we can't accept landing short.
Yep.
We'll go around from here.
Okay.
We'll go around. At full power.
Alpha Fox, Romeo, going around. Good, good. Alpha Fox, shot Romeo, coming real quick.
My bad.
Alpha Fox, shot Romeo.
Okay, that's it.
Let me make sure you clear the runway 1-2 left, you're launching off. Clear the front runway 1-2 left, and then I think you're
ready. Nose up, and all the way up. Okay, there's your engine fire.
line up runway 1 Juliet.
Line up 1 Juliet to Juliet. Juliet.
So just set the attitude. That won't let us speak. That's where you take the back. You take the back. Yep. So keep it at 70 knots the whole way down. Yep. Just let it come down. Lately, across the line.
Across the line?
Yeah, remember we have to cross this line before we clear the runway.
Ah, yes. Yeah.
to the Eastern Open.
Couple from your vantage, the Open.
I just took my seatbelt off.
Right, so a little bit of everything today.
Yeah.
Phenomenal, couple cyclists. Okay, so glide pressures.
Yeah.
Any questions on those?
No. I mean, I think I know the whole concept. It's just, I think the, you know, holding the aeroplane itself is, I think, the only thing I would like to practice.
Yeah.
Yeah. I understand why we're doing it, and
yeah, that's good. Yeah, pretty good with those. No dramas, just try to chase the speed.
Yeah, I know, I caught myself doing that a couple of times.
Yeah. It's because we don't want you to fall into that habit of a performance flight.
Right.
Because that's what your work you have.
Yeah.
Like, keep it. So just bring everything back to that picture. So if the horizon's in that right spot, that you know it's going to give you 70, even if it's not quite giving you that because you've only just set it, it's got to catch up a little bit.
Yeah.
And,
I mean, I've just got in my head trim for 70 because of the briefing, but I know that I shouldn't be doing that.
Yeah, so I'm setting the attitude, trimming the attitude to achieve 70.
Yeah.
Probably more work than what it should.
Looks nice for a 1960s model.
Yeah, the paint job's relatively new.
That would have been interesting.
Yeah, so back on the taxiway.
Oh, right, sorry, I thought you still had it.
Archer Ground, correction, India, Juliet Romeo on Eastern Apron, Jewel, Eastern Departure, request taxi, receive information, Charlie.
Romeo, ground on Bravo, cross
runway
04 left. Taxi holding point Bravo
5,
runway
10
left,
time
18.
Bravo, cross 04 right, 04 left, holding point Bravo 5, runway 10 left, India, Juliet, Romeo.
Thank you, Sophie.